Yeah, as promised, we will be diving straight into the book African Catfish Farmer's Handbook. This first video is going to be just a summary of chapter 1, where we'll be talking about introduction to aquaculture and, of course, reasons why fish farms don't succeed.
This is really beautiful. I see nature everywhere. Tell me about this place.
You are here at Aqua Gardens, a fish farm, a catfish farm, producing around 250 tons of catfish. In 2020, 2021, I hope to do even a little bit more. So we are in the center of Abuja, which actually makes it a very interesting and very special place. Because to have this open space, water available in the middle of a capital of Nigeria is actually very interesting. A lot of things we're going to talk about this farm and use this farm as an example to give people more knowledge about catfish farming.
This is interesting. I'm really excited to be here. I mean, I must mention here that I am privileged to be with Mr. Willie Florent, the author of African Catfish Farmer's Handbook. I mean, my major reason for coming to this farm today is to talk about this book. We are going to be profiling this book. We'll do a thorough review of the book, and hopefully we can now draw deeper insights into what this man has done for the world. African Catfish Farmer's Handbook. Is this really a handbook?
It is a handbook. It is very practically written. It's not information you get from internet by copy and pasting articles. Most of what I've been writing down was from the experience I got after 30 years of fish farming.
Interesting. Well, without wasting much time, I would want to go to the introductory part of this book. I must say, for any of you out there that hasn't gotten this book and you're interested in fish farming, this is indeed one book I advise you go through. Personally, I have gone through it, and when you hear me asking if it's really a handbook, I was just trying to hear from the horse's mouth. So then, the chapter one of this book, African Catfish Farmer's Handbook, talks about reasons why fish farms don't succeed. Why don't we succeed in fish farming?
First of all, I gained all this experience because I've been going to Africa, and I've been living in Africa, and I've been to so many farms. From going to all those farms in Nigeria, but also outside Nigeria, you see a lot of good things, but also a lot of bad things. So in this chapter, I want people, when they start a fish farm, not to fall in the same mistakes that other people have been falling in already. It's better you read my book first and read the first chapter, that you say, okay, this fish farm can work for me. So that's why I said, let me go and review all the years I've been going around, and let me see where things went wrong, and let me write them down. All what I've been writing down has practically happened. It's not theoretically exercise what I've been doing. So we have actually 7 points why fish farms not succeed.
Interesting.
But the first point is the one I call it irreversible. You cannot change it.
Okay.
And that's the hard one. And it has happened a lot when people are coming to me. If you start a fish farm in the wrong location, you put all your money in that location, that location. You cannot carry it to another place again. Your buildings, your concrete ponds, your earth ponds, all is waste. And you say, how can you be so stupid that you start farming fish when there's no water? I'm telling you, it's happening every day. It's such a waste, because that one, you cannot change. You just waste your money. So, the other points are also very crucial. like you can do something about it. You start a fish farm. You think you rely on people who just came from university or came from a practical training and say, I know how to farm fish. But you as an investor, you as the entrepreneur, you rely on them. Or you rely on the so-called experts in the field. These are just horny to sell you something. So if you don't know your own, the business you are going into, you most likely fall into a trap. So be prepared and know what you are doing. Come to places where you see a good fish farm. Read books. Go on internet. Use all the media and all the what is available online to prepare yourself very well. Learn from the good things and from the bad things.
I see another one here. Facility is poorly built and poorly set up. Tell me about that.
Okay, now, in many people's thinking is that fish farming is a low-class business. It's just a hole in the soil. Maybe you put some plastic lining, or you do some stone fishing, or just earthworm because there's clay. You just make a hole in the land, and that is considered a fish pond. No, a fish pond is not to that level. It is on a higher level. There should be an intake, there should be an outlet. It should be thought over very well, the piping systems and so many other things. Has to be done in a proper way so that your farm will stand also after 1 or 2 or 3 years. Because this investment, you cannot pay it back in 2-3 years. The minimum payback investment is at least 4 or 5 years. Okay. So that means your materials have to be durable.
I see. So what you're saying here is that fish farm is actually capital intensive if you really want to do it well?
Yes.
On a large scale level?
It depends a little bit. If you start in a remote area where land is very cheap, you can also opt for extensive fish farming with low densities. But in Nigeria, land is also getting scarce. There's a lot of land issues now going on. Land is not available anyhow. But if you want to do something like in this town that I'm doing, I can only go for intensive fish farming. Because the land is too expensive to do a very big, massive earth pond, put some fish inside, and that is it.
So, I see you also talked about one other factor why fish farms don't succeed, being there is no supervision and the recruitment of staff is not taken seriously.
Yes. So, I always say to everybody who wants to start fish farming is a way of life. You are going to stand up with the fish and you're going to bed with the fish. But some people, they think, I employ and all will be taken care of. By the end of the month, I see my profit and loss. I just collect my profit and that is it. You can have a team of workers, but you need a boss, you need a coach. You need to supervise them, to encourage them to do the right thing. You cannot leave your people just doing whatever they want to do and don't believe them. So if you are an entrepreneur, you are an investor, don't think you can start this fish farm and leave it to somebody else complete. Be a backup. There's not always to be on a meeting point on a weekly or 2 weekly basis. Actually, in the beginning, it should be even more almost on a daily basis.
Okay.
Because you see that the routine is coming up and that people really understand the business.
Sure.
Yeah, so without supervision, a farm will never work.
I see. That is why you need to also recruit your staff seriously, right? Like what then becomes the core qualities you look out for when recruiting the staff for a fish farm?
Fish farming is not a one-man job. It requires a team. So the people you want to work in your farm should be people who are wanting to work as a team member, a team player.
Team player, interesting.
That is number one. Number two, integrity. Integrity means what belongs to the owner should be belonging to the moment. I hope I'm clear on that one. It's one of the paths also, that is one of my points too, that fish farms are not succeeding because of theft.
Oh well, yeah, of course I see that.
Yes.
I see that. Can you talk more about that also?
No, let me go back to the people's ability.
Okay.
There should be a pure interest in fish farming.
Okay.
Even the owner should be interested in fish farming. And when you see the fish swimming in the water, I always make that statement. If you see money swimming in the water, you will not succeed. The first thing you see is you see fish swimming in the water. So the moment you take care of that, the money will come. But if you skip that part, then you will certainly fail. I will give you an example with a person who wants to buy some bananas. Worth something like 300, 400 suckers. You know what the first question was? He asked me, when can I harvest my bananas? He didn't ask me how to take care of the bananas. He just wanted to know when he can harvest. So that man didn't succeed.
He doesn't have the right orientation, the right mentality.
Correct. The orientation is completely wrong. You always see the fish swimming in the water. It's priority number one. The rest will follow automatically.
So, I mean, it's really interesting going through all of these reasons why farms don't succeed. I see our point number six here from our book is lack of funding. Can you tell me more about this?
Oh, when you say lack of funding, I think about a Dutch proverb. You know, we have a saying, the eyes of the older zijn groter dan de maag. Eyes are bigger than the stomach.
Oh!
So let me explain the proverb. The eyes are bigger than the stomach. Somebody is so eager to start a fish farm, he wanted a massively big fish farm. And you see it a lot though, that they are building 20, 30, 40 concrete ponds. Now, having done all this investment, the money has already finished. So the real money now comes in by buying juveniles, buying the feed, and taking care of those fish till they're ready for market. But before the fish is ready for market, the money is already finished.
Yes.
That is lack of funding, and this is not something. This happens to a few people, it happens to a lot of people. And this lack of funding, you will never come back in the rhythm of making profit. But when we do a better review on these chapters, I will give you some examples.
I'm looking forward to that. And your point number seven, theft.
Yes, theft is also, I told you that is one of the basic needs when you get somebody starting your farm, that he has a good sense of integrity, that he's not a thief, that he has love for fish farming. I'm not even particularly interested in people who have done a lot of study or so-called university degrees. If they don't have motivation to learn again as a practical fish farmer, it will not lead to anything. Also there we will go more into it. Theft is in many, many, many ways. And if I tell you all the ways theft can be happening, you will be surprised.
Well, I look forward to hearing that. And just like we said, this is just a tip of the iceberg. I believe that Mr. Willie is going to be doing justice to each and every point he just mentioned in the next video. So stay tuned as we get into learning more from Mr. Willie Florin, a Dutch fish farmer who's had many years of doing this business in Europe and also brought it here to Africa. Looking forward to seeing you join us in subsequent videos as we x-ray the book, African Catfish Farmer's Handbook.